Cheers, everybody. Cheers, cheers, cheers as people join. Get your cups to the sky. Everybody say hi. Hello. What is up, guys? Hi, Miranda. How are you? Cheers, everybody. It's Wednesday. I was kind of singing a cups to the sky. Everybody say hi. I don't know. Just trying to do a little spin on the Wednesday Club theme song today. Hi, Karen. Hi, Ryan. Hey, Carmen. How are you? You guys, happy Wednesday. Hope everybody's doing great. Boy, it's been an amazing week. Me and Lennon, we went to go see the Strokes last weekend. They opened for the Red Hot Chili Peppers, so we got to see the Strokes and the Chili Peppers at Soldier Field. Beautiful night, unbelievable concert. Picked up this t-shirt, oh yeah. What else, let's see. We went to the Cubs game yesterday. Trish and Fran, I don't know if you guys are watching yet, but so funny. You guys know Trish and Fran from, you know, the Wednesday Club and the Plain White Tees community. Jackie, what's up? Trish and Fran were actually at the same Cubs game that me and Lennon went to yesterday in the same row, like 10 seats away from us. It was so funny. So random. So got to see them. So hi guys, if you're watching. Hey Amber, hey Alma. Unsound Sunday, what up? Cool, you guys. So yeah, so it's been a really fun week. Gorgeous summer, you know, trying to squeeze the most that we can out of the Chicago summer. So yeah, it's been a really, really nice week. By the way, anybody that, we also played a show in Milwaukee at the Milwaukee Zoo. Saw some people there, including Trish and Fran. So yeah, technically I kind of saw them twice this week, which is hilarious. But Spunky Alex was there, Megan Schick was there, I know a few other people were there. It was awesome. So thank you guys for hanging with us at the Milwaukee Zoo. This weekend, we got shows in Atlanta and Muskegon, I think, Michigan, like right outside Grand Rapids. So if anybody's around those areas, come hang with us this weekend. Atlanta on Friday and then Muskegon on Saturday. So yeah, if you're around, come hang, you guys. Yeah, let's see. What else do I have to say? Oh, you know, one thing I will say is Trish and Fran were asking about these pint glasses because they missed them the first time around. And I'm pretty much sold out. I might have like one more set of them. But that made me think I should probably like open the vaults and do maybe like an end of summer sale for, you know, for Humans We're Here. Like I said, I've got like one or maybe two more sets of these, which will probably go to Trish and Fran. But, you know, we've got all kinds of stuff. We've got a couple Humans We're Here hoodies left. We've got a few of the band, the artist t-shirts left. Of course, we've got the vinyl and the TLB shot glasses and all that stuff. So I might do an end of summer open the vault up. So if you guys are on the Humans We're Here mailing list, if you guys have already ordered stuff from Humans We're Here, you'll probably get an email about it. Maybe next week we'll try to open that up and try to clear our inventory so that we can gear up for some new stuff. By the way, there is some new stuff coming, you guys. Some new music from a couple Humans artists I'm very excited about. So I know you guys already probably follow Humans We're Here and follow Million Miler, TLB, Robot X, Fairview, One Life, all that stuff. But yeah, we're doing some fun stuff with some of the artists very soon. So there'll be some brand new music coming soon from some artists, some Humans We're Here stuff. So awesome, awesome news on that front. I keep teasing you guys, I know, but Plain White Tees working on some brand new stuff. We played a new song in Milwaukee, so anybody that came to see us last weekend got a little sneak peek of a new song. We'll be playing that this weekend as well in Atlanta and Muskegon. So yeah, come hang with us if you can. We're going along. This is episode number 97, by the way, guys. So happy 97th episode to everybody. And yeah, I'm doing the alphabetical order thing. And this week we were in the C's into the D's. And I think there was even one E in the voting. So yeah, we're moving along with the alphabetical order. It's kind of fun. Like I said, I'm looking on the list, and it's like every batch of 10 songs has at least one song that's like a fan favorite and a couple that are like kind of rare and weird. And it's just like a really fun, I think this is a fun way of doing it. So I'm having fun with it. Hopefully you guys are too. But yeah, this week, Cirque Don LaRue is the number one song. So I'll be playing that one last tonight. Which, by the way, I kind of figured out of all the songs this week, I know you guys love Cirque. We love our Wonders of the Younger here on the Wednesday Club. So I figured that song had a good chance of winning, and it did. So I'll be doing that one last. But yeah, as far as the rest of the songs, I'm looking down at the set list now. Pretty good. Kind of what I would have expected, and a couple maybe that are a few oddballs in there for sure. But yeah, you guys, I'm just stoked. Stoked to be traveling this weekend, playing shows. And like I said, stoked for some things that are coming very soon in the pipeline for Humans We're Here and for Plain White Tees. So yeah, I'm wondering if you guys, there's like a little bit of a giveaway here of what one of the artists that might be working on something soon. Anyway, that's all I'll say about that. Anybody that caught that, if you know, you know. What is it? IYKYK, you know? Anyway, I should start playing music. How about it? Friends don't let friends soon. Oh, yeah, that's true. The F's are coming soon, right? Yeah, what do we got next week? We got E, F. I can't think there's too many songs in the E, F, and G. I wonder if we're going to get to H. I don't think so. I think it's E, F, G. Next week. EFG, yeah, I don't know. I haven't memorized them, of course, but yeah. Oh, Josh Lund says The Strokes. Yeah. I don't know if you caught me earlier, but me and Lennon actually got to see The Strokes last weekend. I've seen them a bunch of times, but it was Lennon's first time, so it was really, really amazing. They opened up for the Chili Peppers. Yeah, super cool. Okay. Well, how about I start playing Oh, what's up, UVD Toys? Got to hang out with them in Columbus a couple weeks ago. Hey, Jen. Oh, wait, somebody's saying Millie. Yep. You guys notice the mustache? Might be some fun Millie stuff happening. Anyway, let's start playing some music, shall we? On this 97th Wednesday Club, you guys. It's a big one. 97. That's the year the band started. Plain White Tees started in 1997. Holy crap. That makes this our 25-year anniversary. I don't even think we've realized that all year. And it's already August. Holy crap. 25 years, you guys. Whew! I don't even feel like I'm 25 years old, let alone we've been in the band 25 years. My God. Yeah, that's crazy. Yeah, we don't have anything planned for a 25-year anniversary. We were going to do a 20-year anniversary show, but that got all screwed up. We were we're in the studio for Parallel Universe as we were, you know, as that show was booked and we had to work with our producer and stuff, so we had to cancel it. But I don't even think there's a 25 anything in the works. Damn it. We should throw something together. I don't know. Anyway, that's a whole other thought, whole other conversation. All right, well, I'm going to start playing some songs here. Like I said, Cirque Don LaRue is your most requested of the night, so that'll be last. But I figured I'd open it with this one. This is a fun one. It's fun to make these set lists, by the way, because I don't put them in order, in case I've never mentioned this, I don't put them in order of the order that they were voted. It's like the most requested song is always last. You guys know that. But then the other four, I actually try to like make setlist style. Like, okay, what would be the best opener? And then like, what would be like I try to make a dynamic setlist. So it's like, you know, you get a little bit of a flow going. So I don't think I've ever talked about that. I wonder if anybody's wondered if like the first song was like the number five requested and they went backwards in order, but that's not how it goes. So anyway, here we go. This is off of the Every Second Counts album. This is Come Back to Me. Here we go.
Everything you say or do, I am always there for you. Whether you're laughing or you're screaming, no one else could take your place. I will always see your face when I'm awake and when I'm dreaming. 'Cause I believe there's a place for you and me in this crazy world. You come running back to me, I'll be here waiting, 'cause I still believe in a world worth claiming. You can see the sad look on my face. You can be in your car heading back to my place.
Second Counts album. That one is a lot of singing, a lot of high. Woo! Feel like I need like a little bit of like oxygen or something after that song. But yeah, I love that one. Actually, when I wrote that one, like when we were putting Every Second Count together, I'm sure I told you guys this before, but like that one sounded like at the time it could have been a single, you know? I mean, when I listen back to Every Second Counts, kind of feel like every song on that album could have been a single. You know, we had Our Time Now, track 2, Come Back to Me, track 3 was Hate, which was a single. Obviously, Our Time Now was as well. And then You and Me, and then Friends Don't Let Friends Dial Drunk, and then Making a Memory, and it's like so on and so forth. It's like all those songs, like, kind of could have been singles. So it's fun to play that one, because yeah, like I said, it's like that one just felt like, man, this feels cool. Just the melodies and stuff were really cool on that song. Anyway. Somebody's agreeing with me there. Oh, Michelle and Jeff, yeah. Yeah, right? That album is a pretty good one. I mean, they're all pretty good. I love them all. They're my babies, but yeah, Every Second Counts. That was like our major label debut, so it was like the stakes were raised, you know? It's like we had to like kill it. We had to come out swinging on that one. So I think we nailed it. And you also have Write You a Song on that album, Let Me Take You There towards the end, you know, so. Anyway, The next song is one that I actually didn't think you guys would pick. This is probably the most rare song in the voting list this week. And freaking awesome song. This is a song that's not out on any album. This was like we recorded this song for a comp CD called Songs from a Scene, which included bands like Backdrop. You guys know Darren and Eric's from TLB, their old band. Close Enough, which is actually the One Life guys' old band. You got Lucky Boys Confusion. You guys know them, hopefully. Some of our best friends. Lucky Boys, who else on that? Penny and the Loafers, Swizzle Tree, just a ton. I hope I'm not forgetting anybody. But yeah, it was like this compilation of a bunch of like really strong, like we had an amazing suburban scene back in the day. And we decided to make this compilation CD, and we had through shows at the Metro to release the CD, and it was so cool. And this was a song that we recorded for that. And this is one of the songs actually that really helped us kind of blow up around Chicago, like really solidified our place in the Chicago music scene. This was a standout song for sure on the compilation. I feel like even all the other bands would agree. It was like this one just kind of felt really cool at the time, which is kind of funny because it's like so dated now, I guess. Because back then, cell phones were kind of just coming out, and they were like I know it sounds crazy. I mean, they were like around in the 90s, those like big box ones, but like the little, you guys remember like the little Nokia phones and stuff, and then there was like the flip phones and everything. Like this song was written back in those days, so it's like has like a built-in weird nostalgia. But yeah, anyway, this was one of the more fun songs on that Songs from a Scene album for sure. So yeah. Shout out to anybody that was around back in the day. I know Megan Chick loves this one. She's asked me to play it before. But yeah, anybody else from way back in the day or anybody that has, you know, tracked it down on YouTube or something to listen to it, this is for you. This is called Cell Phone Number. Here we go.
I just had to take a chance. I can't defend myself against a pretty face. I get all flustered and my heart begins to race. And by the time the night was all through, I gave up my digits to you. You got it for a reason, so quit teasing me and make that call.
Ah, the good old days. That is pre-Stop, you guys. That was like in between Come On Over and Stop, that song. Just so you know where it fits in the timeline there. Yeah, fun one, right? I love that song. And it was really cool. Actually, it's funny because it kind of had some Million Miler production. It was like there's like a synth. There's like a synth line, believe it or not, for Plain White Tees. Back in the day, we had like, yeah, that song had like a synth line. Because we thought like, oh, cell phone number. It's like super like modern. So we got to have like synthy stuff in there. And there's like all kinds of samples, like phone numbers being dialed and like, finally, at the end of the song, the girl answers, and that's how it ends. It's really, really cute. You guys should go check it out on YouTube if you have never heard that real recording of that song. I'm sure you could look up cell phone number Plain White Tees on YouTube, and pretty sure you'll be able to find it. But yeah, it's a cool song, so check it out. And the recording, yeah, it's cool. It starts out with like me dialing, and then it's like rings, and then it's like a voicemail, like, and so I hang up. Song starts in the middle of the song, I call again, and it's like a busy signal, and then at the end of the song I dial again, and then it ends with hello, and then it ends. It's real cute. Okay, cool. This next song, another deep cut. You guys are hitting me with the deep cuts this week. I guess kind of there was a few deep cuts to choose from this week, so I shouldn't be too surprised. But this one's kind of a tough one. This one has an awesome key change. By the way, has anybody listened to the new Panic at the Disco album yet? Because I'm like a little bit torn. It's got to grow on me. Like, I love Panic, you guys know, is like one of my favorite bands. And the album is just kind of weird. Like, there's like every song is like a weird key change in the middle of the song, and then it changes again. And it's like, it's kind of hard to follow. But I got to keep, you know, as a fan, I'm going to keep listening and like, you know, give it the benefit of the doubt, because I love Brendan. He's like, that guy is a incredible performer, songwriter, singer, you know, love that guy. But yeah, this album, I was super excited about it, and it didn't hit me on first listen the way Panic usually does. So I don't know, I'd be curious if anybody else has listened to it and what your thoughts are. But I really think, yeah, it's like weird, every song has the weird key changes. I'm like, huh. Like, it almost sounds, you know, Brendan did, Broadway. He did Kinky Boots on Broadway. And it almost feels like, kind of like, I know Panic has always been theatrical, but it kind of feels like he's like really going like Broadway style. And I feel like sometimes it works, and sometimes I'm like, oh man, I don't know. It's like a little bit hard to follow. But again, as a fan, I want to give it a few more listens. Because yeah, he can kind of do no wrong. He's pretty amazing. So I'll bet it grows on me. But yeah, anyway, the reason I bring that up is because A, that album came out on Friday, but B, this next song has a really cool key change. I know I'm doubting when Panic does it, but I'm like, this one's amazing though. But no, this one I feel like works and goes with the song. You don't even really notice it, which is kind of what key change is supposed to do. But anyway, this was a B-side off of our latest album, Parallel Universe. Oh shoot, Schick just wrote a novel and I missed it. But anyway, yo, this is a B-side off of Parallel Universe. This is a song that I wrote with my boy Tim Lopez. And this was a fun one. This was really cool to write with him. Because I feel like you can definitely hear both of our influences in this song. Some of the lyrics, I think, are total Tim lyrics, and I think some of the melodies are totally my style and some lyrics and stuff. So anyway, does that sound in tune to you guys? That sounds good. Sharp or flat. Sorry, guys. There we go. Okay. So anyway. Wow, I haven't really tuned. I've never had to retune really on Wednesday Club, except when I drop to D and stuff. But anyway, deeper and deeper, you guys. Let's do this. Also, kind of hard to play and sing.
Underneath the red, white, and turquoise sky, I can see the sun setting in your eyes. Close them up tight as your lips meet mine. I can feel our hearts beat in 4/4 time. Yo! On the waves makes you move your hips. If you say the word, then I'll dive right in, 'cause we're in love. We're in love. Deeper and deeper I sink into you. There's not a thing in this world I won't do for you.
See me sweating on that one? A lot of high notes.
Deeper and deeper.
I feel like I do that every time I end that song. That's my favorite part. It sounds like a pirate. For some reason, that melody, it's like a pirate.
Oh,
I don't know. Anyway, deeper and deeper, you guys. That one was I was surprised you guys picked that one. That one wouldn't have been on in my top five for if I had to guess what you guys were picking. Yeah, that one and cell phone number, definitely the two curveballs, I think, this week for you guys. So thank you. This next song, and I was just talking about when I have to tune my guitar to drop D, we'll check it out. Let's see. Good enough. Okay, anyway, this next song is called Cinderella's Story. First appeared on the Come On Over album, which is credited as I co-write with Eric Varell, because on that album, I know I probably do this every time as well, but there. Eric had this riff. And I loved it so much. And I basically was like, hey, dude, you mind if I try writing a song around that riff? So on Come On Over, it's...
I saw you with him today. The boy you took my
home. You know, the riff, which is really awesome. But it was kind of hard to play and it was a little slower. And so again, in between Stop and All That We Needed, we actually did a new version of Cinderella Story where we just kind of dropped it to D because the song was in D, and we just kind of made it harder and like a more rock version of the song. I think I changed a couple of the lyrics to make it a little bit more like hit a little harder, personal. So that's the version that I always play on the Wednesday call. Basically just because it's a little easier than having to play this riff the whole time.
Of my life, but it's just
There you go. The hybrid version of Cinderella Story with Eric's awesome guitar part and then the new hard rock version. Yeah. Oh, Eric Burrell's on here. What's up, Eric? Oh, perfect timing. He's like, oh, his spider senses were tingling. His spidey senses. He's like, Tom's butchering my song as we speak. I gotta tune in. Kick-ass. Oh, thanks, dude. You know, it's funny is I'm never really able to read the comments, but for some reason I think my spidey senses were like, oh, there's Eric. Made me like zoom laser focus in there. All right, you guys. Hey, the 97th episode of the Wednesday Club is about to come to an end. We got one more song tonight. Your number one song, Cirque Don LaRue. So I'm going to cheers you guys. Like I said, I'm going to be putting a bunch of stuff, opening up the vaults on humanswerehere.com. So if there's any items, some artist t-shirts, Humans Were Here sweatshirts. I think there might be a couple Christmas sweatshirts left from last year. I don't know. I got to go through the inventory and just put them back up on the site. But yeah, you guys will get an email about it. If you're not subscribed, go to humanswerehere.com, subscribe for the email list. Because yeah, there's only a couple of each of these items left. So if you happen to miss out, like I said, I ran into Trish and Fran Jansta at the Cubs game, and they were like, hey, do you still have any more of those pint glasses? And I'm like, I think I do. And I just checked and I literally have like one or two. So yeah, but that made me think I should just reopen the vault, put everything that I have laying around just out, and let people get it and like clear house over here. So I'm gonna try to work on that by next week. So like I said, you guys will get an email from Humans Were Here from the mailing list about that. But yeah, thanks again for hanging with me. Thanks for all the votes. We got one more song. I'm gonna finish my beverage and then we're gonna do it. Oh, Jeffrey Smith has beer in his pint. Oh yeah. I'm glad you guys are still using those. I mean, honestly, it's so fun for me. You guys know I've got like, I collect like mugs and stuff. So it's fun because every Wednesday I'm like, I wake up and I'm come down and have my coffee and I'm like, oh, it's Wednesday. I grab the Wednesday Club mug, you know, that's what I have my coffee in. And then I use this thing every Wednesday to celebrate with you guys. So anyway, last song of the night. Thanks again. Yeah, look out for some new music coming very soon and more, not just music, but a lot of stuff coming soon. A lot of really fun stuff. So yeah, follow along, humans, all the artists. I know you guys already do. So, but in case you don't, just a warning that there's going to be a lot of good stuff coming. Okay, here we go. Your most requested song from the Wonders of the Younger album. This is Cirque Don LaRue. I wanna have a party in the middle of the street. Invite
the surf, Thomas LaRue. Check your troubles at the door. You won't need them anymore. Leave reality outside. Come along for the ride. But just remember, while you're watching us do the things that we do, sad clowns make us laugh. All the pretty girls get cut in half while the sad clowns make us laugh. I wanna make girls with the face. I wanna throw it down with the clowns that I mean. I wanna have a party in the middle of the street. I wanna have a party in the middle of the street. I wanna have a party in the middle of the street. Invite all the carnies and the crazy eyes.
All right, you guys, thank you so much. Love you all. Yeah, I don't think next week will be a Wednesday club. I think I'm traveling next Wednesday. But the week after that should be a go. So I will see you guys in 2 weeks for the, wow, that'll be the 98th episode. Woo! We're coming down. We're coming down to that 100th episode. Excited for that landmark. But yeah, anyway, 97. Was pretty amazing, I'd say. So thank you guys for all your votes. Thanks for hanging out, tuning in. And yeah, everybody be safe. If you can, come hang out with Plain White Tees this weekend. Playing Atlanta on Friday. And I believe it's Muskegon. I think it's Muskegon. I keep saying that. It's around Grand Rapids, Michigan on Saturday. So if you're around those areas, come hang with us. Let's see, yeah, subscribe to the Humans We're Here mailing list, humanswerehere.com, because I'm going to open the vault, all the stuff, everything that I still have laying around in the warehouse is going to be, I'm going to put it out there for you guys, so it's going to be like your last chance on some of these items, so subscribe if you aren't already, and yeah, I'll see you guys in 2 weeks, love you, everybody be safe, have fun, have a great couple weeks. Enjoy the end of the summer. I know I am, for sure. It's so beautiful out here in Chicago, so I'm loving it. But anyway, thank you guys so much. Much love, and I will see you all very soon. Okay, bye.